Christian Karasevich from ChristianKOnline.com and Facebook.com/AskCK. So YouTube recently rolled out a new feature called YouTube Video Cards. Now these are somewhat of a replacement for annotations. Now they're not replacing annotations just yet, but what's really great about them is that they give you a new way to engage and to interact with your customers on every single one of your YouTube videos. Basically, you get to add a call to action to every video that you can use to drive your viewers back to your website, to your products, to merchandise, and so on. So let's take a look at how to add YouTube video cards to your YouTube videos. Here we are in the YouTube video interface. If you want to add YouTube video cards to your videos, follow these instructions. Step one, you want to locate a video that you want to add a card to. You can do this by going to the video manager, which you can get to two ways. One is to click your photo in the top right-hand corner, or you can select video manager. Next, you want to decide which video you want to add a card to. Let's add it to this one. We're going to click the edit option and then go to the card section at the top. At this point, we're now in the YouTube video cards interface where we're going to see a preview of our video, a playhead showing us how long the video is, and an add card button. Now, before you go about adding a card, it's important to remember you can have up to 5 video cards per video. And this is important because some videos might have one card that they want to use to link to, say, a more detailed tutorial. Other videos might want to also have an option to get someone to sign up for their email newsletter. Or even if you've got, say, a download associated with a topic you're presenting in your video, you can include a card for that as well. So to add a card, you want to drag this blue playhead to where you want the card to go. For example, if we're linking to more information, we might want to add it here. I'm going to click Add Card, and now I get some options to choose from. So if I'm going to link to, say, a video or a playlist, I can add a card for that. If I'm trying to link to merchandise, I can also add a specific card for that. Or if I'm doing a fundraiser project or running a Kickstarter campaign, there's a fundraising option as well. However, most users are going to use the associated website link. That's what we're going to use for this example. So once we click Create, we want to make sure we have our YouTube account linked to our website. If you don't, you can click the settings option to get there. Next, you want to paste in the URL that you want to link to from your YouTube video. Here, it's going to pull back the information from my website, and I'm going to make some text adjustments, and I'm going to add a call to action. In this case, I'm sending someone back to my website, so I'm just going to say visit website. You want to make sure that when you're adding your call to action, that's a strong call to action that encourages your viewers to take an action based on what the content is you're presenting them with. For example, if you're going to give them something to download, maybe your call to action is download. If you want to get them to opt into an email list, you might want to say something like subscribe or sign up. The last thing you need to do is you need to choose an image. Now, YouTube is pulling all of this information from my website, so I don't have an associated image that's sized to fit this space. The image size you need to use is 150 by 150. And if you need a tutorial on how to create this image, I actually have a template available at ChristianKOnline.com/videocards that you can download to create your own YouTube video cards image. Once you've got your image prepared, simply click the upload option and it will show up now once you've clicked the create card. So if we want to see what this looks like, all we have to do is play through our video, or we can just move the playhead to where the video card is at. In this case, you're going to see an eye pop up along with the text that we entered and the image we selected and the call to action. If you want to delete a video card, you can do this by clicking the pencil icon, selecting the trash can, and starting over. So that's how to add YouTube video cards to your YouTube videos. If you have any ideas, comments, or suggestions, please leave those below. And don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. And if you'd like additional YouTube marketing tips and tutorials, check out my blog, ChristianKOnline.com.